It'd be difficult to overstate the role that my father has played in my competitive gaming journey. When I was growing up playing chess, my father taught me to play chess when I was like 4 years old. And from that point forward, I did well in my first big chess tournament like third grade. And my dad then he was absolutely my chess coach, my chess guy, whatever you want to say. He drove me to every tournament. He would get me food between rounds. Like, you'd come out of like this long chess game. Like, chess games are much longer than match tournaments, for those who may not be familiar. Like, so you're sitting there at that board for just hours, and you come out and there's just like hot pizza just like waiting for you. Like, that makes a big difference. He was an unbelievable supporter of me in just everything that I did. And I mean, then when I was flying to tournaments later in my life, just this is just in the last few years, when I was a GP grinder, my dad drove me to the airport every time. His loss, it's just like, it's impossible to describe the extent to which he supported me competitively and the amount that his loss hurts me in a competitive sense, I guess. My father, last year, in July, was hospitalized for a brain aneurysm. It was really sudden. He was like not sick at all, like very clear from like the medical staff, it's like really bad. He like passes away like a week and a half later. It was like pretty brutal because we didn't see it coming at all. Like, describing my year as far as like 2018 goes is really hard, because it is both, I think, the year in which the best thing that has ever happened to me happened in winning the Pro Tour, and the thing in which the worst thing that has ever happened to me happened in losing my father. So I have like very conflicted and mixed feelings about it. Yeah, I mean, it was just weird. I mean, my dad would have been so happy. I mean, it's obvious. I mean, everybody can say this, but I'll say it because it's true regardless of that. I mean, my father would have been so happy to see it. I mean, my father was one of the few people I've ever met who's as competitive as I am. I mean, I guess I know plenty of competitive Magic players who are in a similar boat, but, you know, and so he felt every loss that I had and felt every success with me all the way through chess and all the way through Magic. I mean, to give a sense of this, my father used to say he couldn't watch my chess games because he couldn't handle the pressure that was happening. Even though he wasn't even participating, he just was so nervous and so invested, you know, and the Magic was the same. And so this win meant everything to me, but it also would have meant everything to him. When we used to play games against my mom, she'd let us win so that we'd feel good. When he used to play against my dad, he would beat the crap out of us so that we'd know what winning meant. That was how my parents did things. I mean, he really got it. I mean, for another example, the point at which my father and I stopped playing chess is the point at which I started beating him, because we would like have like shouting matches over the board. We were very, very competitive. I always loved my father. I don't want to say like this yelling was like mean or anything. It was totally understood that both of us just desperately wanted the win. And so for someone like that, winning at this level just means everything. So Pro Tour Sydney, you know, I qualified for that one. My dad had wanted to go to Australia like his whole life. He came with me to the tournament, like he bought a ticket, was it paid for mine. We stayed for like a week after, and it was like one of the best trips I've ever taken. It was really nice that I got to like do that with him before he died, that like, you know, about a year before we got to take this trip that was like kind of fulfilling a dream for both of us lifelong. And I mean, he had a great time at that tournament. Just like the spectacle of the Pro Tour, the lights, the camera, you know, just everything. He went back into coach mode. He had food waiting for me between rounds. I mean, he had the time of his life at that event. And so I think it's nice that we got to do that before he died. Proving that I am good at something matters. I mean, that's the essence of any competitor, I guess, to me. You know, proving that, look at how good I am at this thing. I can prove it. I can show that I'm among the best. And he totally got that. He was precisely on the same page.